Now, you mentioned George Floyd's murder, and I did want to ask you, how would you characterize Governor Walz's leadership in the aftermath of George Floyd's murder and what you saw in Minnesota in those ensuing days and weeks?
You know, it was a lack of response and a lack of timely response. We had, again, Minneapolis was burning for 3 days before Governor Walz took action. They allowed the third police precinct to be burned to the ground. And I think that sent a message that if you were going to allow an establishment that is to provide order and peacekeeping within the area burned to the ground and then not rebuild it, that right there was a show of those that are protesting and then violently rioting, millions of dollars of damage throughout all of those businesses, people trying to protect them on their own because Governor Walz was nowhere to be found. We had news reporters locally that were saying, "Governor, where are you?" until he finally resurfaced again and took action. So it was a delayed response that never should have gotten as out of hand as it did.
A delayed response. Did he ever provide an explanation and or context for what happened in those days?
You know, he did. There were some quotes that said that if it was a failure, it was on him, but yet it was past the point and there wasn't steps to rebuild and to reimagine that again. Again, the third precinct should have been rebuilt immediately right where it is. I understand that's a city issue, that is a local control city issue, but the governor could have influence because it was unprecedented. And I think that set off a chain reaction negatively across our country and different things that you saw across the world too.